With a brand new season of Battle Royale comes a brand new set of weekly challenges to complete all throughout season 8 and eventually unlock the super secret ultra rare discovery skin, who will undoubtedly be a super rare skin to unlock as it is only available to unlock during season 8. So with that, make sure you definitely complete all of your weekly challenges every week so you can get closer and closer to ultimately getting your hands on the most elusive skin of season 8. And to help you guys out all season long, we're going to be posting the weekly challenges early and telling you guys the best and most efficient ways to complete each and every one of them. What's up guys, and welcome back to the Simply Fortnite channel. Thanks for stopping by. If you are new around here, feel free to subscribe with your post notifications turned on by clicking that little bell icon. That way you'll always be notified by YouTube whenever a new video goes up on the channel. If you guys are enjoying season 8 so far, let us know by dropping a like on this video and giving it a big old thumbs up. And last but not least, make sure to let us know down in the comments below what your favorite season 8 skin is so far. Now without further ado, let's jump back into the world of Fortnite Battle Royale and take a look at the Season 8 Week 2 challenges. So if you guys didn't know, challenges here in Season 8 actually work a little differently than before, as you can now actually activate the Party Assist feature on any challenge that you please, whether it be a daily challenge or a weekly challenge, and make it so that you and your squad can actually complete one challenge at the same time. So definitely make sure you're taking advantage of this as much as you can, because it's actually going to make completing challenges a lot easier. For instance, if you have a challenge that says drop at this point or visit two different named locations in a single match, you can drop to one spot and your partner can drop to one spot and you'll get that challenge done immediately rather than having to go to each spot individually by yourself. Anyways, as always with these weekly challenges, because these challenges do indeed leak early from the in-game files, there is a slight chance that one or two of them might end up changing on Thursday when the challenges actually go live. So it is always a good idea to double check the challenges on the main menu to make sure that everything is in order. Just like last season, we've got 7 challenges here every week, 3 hard ones and 4 regular ones, with the hard ones granting you 10 battle stars upon completion, and the regular ones granting you 5 battle stars upon completion. And once you actually complete 4 out of these 7 challenges this week, you will automatically gain an extra 5,000 XP right away. Now without further ado, let's take a look at all the week 2 challenges here in season 8. Our first challenge this week is going to be deal damage to descending supply drops. Now because these challenges do leak early, we're not always sure how much damage you need to do in some cases, or how many chests you need to open in other cases, and that is actually the case here. We're not exactly sure how much damage we need to do to the descending supply drops, but we do know that that is in fact the first challenge. This of course really is not too difficult at all, as all you have to do is listen for the sound of an incoming supply drop, then find it and shoot it until you complete the challenge. This challenge is definitely going to be completed the easiest in any larger team-based limited time mode, as those modes tend to have the most supply drop drops, so that would definitely be my number one suggestion for completing this challenge very quickly, but all in all, this one really should not be too difficult. Our second challenge here in week 2 of season 8 is going to be deal damage to opponents with a pirate cannon. Once again, we're not exactly sure how much damage we're going to have to deal here, but this is our very first official Season 8 item-related challenge. Of course, the cannons do spawn all over the map, primarily at the new pirate camps, which I believe there are actually 7 camp locations in total, one outside of Lazy Lagoon, one on the side of the volcano, one just west of the diner at Dusty Divot, one just south of the soccer stadium outside of Tilted Towers, one on the mountain where the house with the basketball court used to be outside of Salty Springs, and also one on the bridge connecting the desert biome to the grass biome just northeast of Fatal Fields. Now for this challenge, all you're going to need to do with the pirate cannon is hit enemies enough to rack up that damage count, and I think this is actually going to be a lot easier once again in either a big team limited time mode or in a squad based mode where you have more targets to try and hit at once. Moving on, challenge number 3 this week is going to be get eliminations at Salty Springs or Haunted Hills. Now, once again, the leaks don't specify how many kills we're going to need for this challenge, but pretty much every single time we've had a challenge in the past that requires us to get eliminations, we need to get at least 3 eliminations in order to complete the challenge. So my guess here is that this challenge is going to end up being get 3 eliminations at Salty Springs or Haunted Hills. And for this one, well, it's actually pretty self-explanatory. Just land at Salty or Haunted and kill 3 people. Keep in mind, this does not need to be done in one game and it can span across multiple matches if need be, but it really should not be too difficult if you end up getting a good weapon off of spawn. Challenge number 4 this week is going to be a stage challenge, although the leaked files actually only specify 2 of the stages, and I would assume there's probably going to be anywhere from 3 to 5 stages by the end of it. With that said though, stage 1 is gain health from apples, and stage 2 is gain health using medkits. My best suggestion for this challenge is to first find some apples and then a medkit when you get to that stage, and just build some ramps up and then jump off of them, deal some fall damage to yourself and then heal up using the apples and then the medkit. Keep in mind though here, because this is a staged challenge, it cannot be done in one match and you can only complete one stage per match. So don't try and do all the stages in one match because it will not work after you complete one stage. Challenge number 5 this week is going to be yet another stage challenge. This time though, we do actually have all the stages leaked to us. Stage 1 is going to be land at the block, stage 2 is going to be land at Dusty Divot, stage 3 is land at Polar Peak, stage 4 is land at Snobby Shores, and the final stage, stage 5, is land at Paradise Palms. In all honesty, this challenge could not be any easier, as all you have to do is literally just land at each one of these locations and you'll have the challenge complete. It will take 5 matches to do, but it is definitely the easiest challenge of all the challenges that we have this week. Continuing on with the list here, challenge number 6 for week 2 of season 8 is going to be search a chest in different named locations in a single match. Unfortunately for this one, we do not know once again how many chests we're going to have to search in order for this challenge to be complete. But hands down, the best way to complete this challenge is going to be to land at areas that are very close in proximity. For instance, Polar Peak and Frosty Flights, or Tilted Towers and Loot Lake, or Junk Junction and Haunted Hills. Just land at one of these spots and then move your way down the map from one named location to the other, searching for chests. This, once again, I think is going to be the easiest to do in a big team limited time mode because simply you're not going to have as many enemies trying to kill you while you're traveling on your side of the island. Finally, we've got challenge number 7 here to wrap up week 2 of season 8, and this challenge is going to be to visit the furthest north, south, east, and west points of the island. Now this one does not have to take place in one game. Quite honestly, I think that would be impossible. But you will need to visit all 4 of these locations at some point in order to complete the challenge. Now just looking at the map from a bird's eye view, the furthest east point seems to be right around the old mansion just south of Lonely Lodge, the furthest north point seems to be just north of Junk Junction, the furthest west point is just south of Snobby Shores, and the furthest south point is just south of Lucky Landing. This one is definitely going to require some patience, especially because we don't really know if there's going to be one specific spot you have to visit or if it's just going to be a general area. For that, we're going to have to wait and see, but really, this one is just, you're going to have to land at each one of these spots off of spawn. That's probably going to be the easiest way to complete that there. But there you guys have it. Those are all of the Season 8 Week 2 challenges and how to complete them in the best and most efficient ways possible. As you guys heard me mention at the start of the video, by completing these weekly challenges every single week, eventually we are going to be able to unlock the new Discovery skin, which is going to be just like the Blockbuster skin or the Enforcer skin or the AIM skin in the past, and that skin, inevitably, is going to play a big part in the overall storyline progression here, moving from Season 8 to Season 9 down the road. But in order to actually unlock the Discovery skin this season, you're going to need to complete at least 55 individual weekly challenges, so definitely get started on your challenges now because we're not going to be able to unlock the Discovery skin until week 8 of season 8, which is quite a few weeks down the road, and the more you knock out of the way now, the less you have to worry about later. So I personally would suggest trying to knock out as many challenges as fast as possible now so that you can be prepared come week 8 and you can get your Discovery skin right away. As I mentioned also at the start of the video, we are going to be posting weekly challenge guides every single week here in Season 8, so if you guys always want to be up to date with all the latest weekly challenges, make sure you are subscribed to the channel. With that being said though, that does effectively wrap up today's video. Be sure to let us know down in the comments below what your favorite Season 8 skin is so far. Of course, if you guys enjoyed this video or if you just found it helpful, be sure to drop a like on it and give it a big old thumbs up as it would be much appreciated. And if you are brand new here to the Simply Fortnite channel, feel free to go ahead and subscribe with your post notifications turned on, that way you will never miss another upload. Once again, thank you guys so much for tuning in, and until next time, take it easy, have an awesome rest of your day, and we'll see you guys on the Battle Bus. Peace out.